Journalist Cokie Roberts, who died 2 years ago, paved the way for many women in our field, setting an example with her political reporting and analysis. But to those who were closest to her, she was also known as a fearless matriarch, beloved wife, and cherished friend and mentor. I sat down with her husband, Steve Roberts, to talk about his new book, Cokie, A Life Well Lived, and what her legacy has meant for journalists and women across the country. Steve Roberts, thank you so much for joining us.
Great pleasure, Judy.
What a wonderful book. What a wonderful picture. Cokie, A Life Well Lived. That's true, and we still miss her.
Every day. But I did this book, Judy, because there were two Cokies. There was the public Cokie, which listeners of public broadcasting know well, public radio know well. And there were countless young women over many years who saw her on TV or listened to her on the radio and said, I can be that smart. I can be that strong. I don't have to hide who I am. I can be myself. And it was enormously powerful model, the public Cokie. But there was the private Cokie who did something good for someone else every single day. She lived the gospel, Judy.
You're right. There was the Cokie we all thought we knew, the journalist, the public person. But there was the daughter, the sister, the mother, the wife, and someone who lived a very full life, engaged in her faith, engaged in her family, engaged with and as you say, with so many friends. She had a
powerful... friends was, and particularly her female friends, Judy. She had lots of guy friends, but she had a special feeling for women in all sorts of ways. Young women who looked up to her, and at her office in ABC, there was a line outside the door. There could have been a sign saying, the doctor is in, you know, saying, because they wanted role models. And here was Cokie with two kids, long marriage, six grandkids. And these young women who were working with her in Forest said, that's who I want to be. I want that life. You know this yourself as a mother of in this business. You were a real pioneer, too. You were part of that whole generation, Judy. And there's a passage in the book about a woman who was very associated with this show for many, many years. Linda Winslow was the producer here. And when she had an operation for ovarian cancer, who was the person who sat for hours outside the waiting room was Cokie, because Linda's family wasn't here and someone had to be there, and Cokie was absolutely determined she was going to be there for her friend.
And Linda has never, you know, the two of them were very close, but it was Linda Winslow, our former executive producer, but there's a story about our current executive producer, Sarah Just, who speaks about when they were working together at ABC.
She had a lot to do with Sarah taking the job here, encouraging her and mentoring her. And but Sarah's story was so instructive because Cokie loved doing needlework. She did a piece of needlework for every one of our six grandchildren. But there was another point to it. She wanted to say, not so subtly, I'm not a guy in a suit. I'm a woman here, and I am doing womanly things. And Sarah tells a story about sitting in a conference room talking about recipes with Cokie and doing their needlework. And as the guys are filing in, Sarah says, maybe we should stop talking about recipes and maybe we should put away our needlework. Cokie says, no. No, we're not putting it away, because they need to know that we are women. And that was part of what was so important about her, Judy, because she was a radical and a traditionalist at the same time. And no matter how visible she became, she always said, we cannot, as women, lose sight of the roles we've always played as the nurturers and the caregivers and the keepers of the family flame.
And she somehow just instinctively had that sense that that was something that was important for her to do. But it was not only that, Steve Roberts. It was, I mean, she had this extraordinary career as a very successful, brilliant journalist. It covered Capitol Hill, covered American politics for all those years. Where did that come from? Clearly her father and then mother served in Congress. So it was in the family. But she really got politics.
Yes, her mother and father served a total of 46 years. We do not believe in term limits in our family. But it went way, way back. Her seventh birthday party was at the Capitol, Judy. When she was 12 years old, she was giving tours of the Capitol for her father's constituencies. So it was in her bones. It was in her fingertips, that understanding. But it was not just understanding, Judy. It was respect.
Yeah.
You know, she believed in the life of politics as a noble occupation, and she believed in Congress as the epitome of American democracy. And she brought that. She was very tough and she was very skeptical. She was also respectful of the political life, which set her apart from a lot of political reporters.
She believed in holding them accountable, but doing it in a respectful way and respecting the work that they do. One thing I want to ask you, you knew her so well, and journalism has changed. I mean, at the time she passed 2 years ago, journalism was already going through turmoil. Today, even more turmoil. What do you think she would be saying about what we're going through right now?
Well, I think two things. I think she would be very regretful of the way journalism has become a target of some politicians who run against journalists and demean journalists and use them as a foil and a target. But I think she would be very strong in saying, we can't let this turmoil unmoor us from our basic principles. And she would say, with all the ways we've changed, all of the new technologies, all of the new pressures, let's not forget what our core mission is and what our core values are. And I think she would have been very strong in saying that.
One of many, many good lessons that come from the pages of this book, Cokie, A Life Well Lived. Steve Roberts, thank you very much.
Judy, it's been a real pleasure.